Biden has just announced 6 full pardons in these, the final days of 2022. The White House has described these 6 people as individuals who have served their sentences and have demonstrated a commitment to improving their communities and the lives of those around them. Joining me right now, NBC White House correspondent Mike Memley, who is on detail in St. Croix. Yes, he's traveling with the president, but I like to give you a hard time given where you are, my friend. Anyway, let's talk about this new round of pardons. What do you know?
Well, Alex, obviously all presidents have this right to grant pardons and clemencies, and it's often interesting to see how they choose to exercise that power. So in the case of the 6 individuals that the president has granted clemency pardons to today, 5 of them are people who had served time for drug-related offenses. And of course, one of the stories of 2022, underrated compared to other stories, of course, that we've been covering, but was the president taking steps in the direction of decriminalizing marijuana, for instance. He earlier this year did grant some pardons to individuals who have and were serving jail time for marijuana possession charges. I want to highlight, though, one of the other individuals who is on this list today. Her name is Beverly Ann Tomas. She's 80 years old from Columbus, Ohio. At the age of 33, she was charged and convicted ultimately of second-degree murder. She killed her husband while she was pregnant. Now, this ultimately, as the White House puts it, was found to be one of the first documented cases of battered woman syndrome that led to only a 5-year sentence. It was one of the first instances of this, as it's been known, being actually brought into consideration during a judicial proceeding. And so, of course, we know President Biden, over the course of his career, the author of the Violence Against Women Act, is choosing, I think, in this case, to highlight a case that shows how much progress has been made, but how more could still be done. Now, I mentioned the benign prerogative, as it was called by Alexander Hamilton, this presidential right to a pardon. It happened. Just so happens, as anybody who saw Hamilton knows, he's from here in the U.S. Virgin Islands.